for battle.
All right, this will be. I'm going to do a regular intro for this. I'll go back to doing the original intro because this is going to be my piece to camera as my attempt to do the unthinkable. So I have an app on my phone that can generate anything for me out of a selection of things. Like if you give it a list of football teams, it'll generate you one of the themes. And I put my list of 25 bands on the list to say, generate me a band and I will listen to a song by that band. What I was going to do is also then go through and look at their top 15 songs or top 25 songs themselves and do that list and then see what it pulled up. It happened to pull up the band that is notoriously difficult to get reactions uploaded on YouTube. And that'd be BABYMETAL. But I have a workaround. I said to myself, if it picks BABYMETAL, I was going to do one song, Kingslayer, by Bring Me the Horizon featuring BABYMETAL. I hope because it's not actually BABYMETAL that it goes through. Oh, and if you're going to sit there and ask, tell me you're not really a BABYMETAL fan throughout this reaction, always remember this. I got this when I was 17 years old. You see that? That's Sue, Yui, and Moa. Oh yeah, I know the girls. I know who they are. That's just to let you know. Now, I know that in this song, it's not Yui, it's Momo in the band this time. I hope because it's bringing me the horizon, I'll get away with this. If I don't, you'll never see this. So, who cares? I'll fiddle with it heavily if I have to. Well, go to the reaction before YouTube takes it from me. Alright, here comes the deadly one. BABYMETAL, or Bring Me the Horizon between BABYMETAL and their song Kingslayer. We'll see how this goes. I don't trust this. I just don't trust it. Not the song. I don't trust this ability to make it to YouTube because I don't trust... BABYMETAL. I do trust Bring Me the Horizon. I think Bring Me the Horizon will be reasonable. Because it's Bring Me the Horizon featuring BABYMETAL, I kind of hope that I can get away with it. Now, as the song goes, I have heard this song a lot. This is my favorite song in the world. This is the song that I said would open the floodgates. That you're going to see tons of artists start asking BABYMETAL to perform with them. On one of their songs. It happened here, then it happened with F-Hero, but that's more of a F-Hero repaying, or BABYMETAL repaying F-Hero, because F-Hero is in a BABYMETAL song. This will be, and then they did Electric Cowboy. So I hope this video makes it. I hope it does. If it does, I will be so happy because I love this song. I love this band, BABYMETAL. I like Bring Me the Horizon too. I love Bring Me the Horizon. And actually, this song has made me like them more than I did. I love all this. In this comment section, if you could give me recommendations for Bring Me the Horizon, that'd be great. Give me recommendations for BABYMETAL too. Though, I already know what songs to do. But you can still give me recommendations. Just so you know, those songs are going to be hard. What I have noticed, and this has not been backed by anybody, what I've noticed is that BABYMETAL's songs that came out before the girls were 18 are a lot harder to get up on YouTube. It seems like their newer stuff is a lot easier. It might be because the muse is starting to realize the benefit of reaction channels, or they're starting to realize Or they're realizing these girls are adults now and they can make their own decisions on their own band. But I digress. Let's do it. This is not by, on women. This is not the official. This is, by a different guy that edited the video a little bit better.
Evil!
What the hell is happening now?
The Rebellion have executed a cyber attack on our network.
We are in retrograde.
Filthy havoc! How bad is it?
The virus has taken us back to N64 level graphics, but it could get as bad as the Sega Saturn.
Motherfuckers!
I need to know everything you know.
We don't know much currently. But they call it
Project Kingslayer.
To do it's like, YouTube, please don't take this away. This is awesome. I love this. Oh, I get goosebumps. That's the thing about me. When I love a song, I get goosebumps every time I hear it.
For the other side, feeling nothing ever seems quite right. Are you still in the drain pipe, getting off from pain like?
I need to know where your loyalties lie. Tell me, are you gonna back up? Do you really wanna twist the knife in the belly?
So, just so you know, I'm gonna pause it a lot because of BABYMETAL. This is awesome. I hope we get more things like this, because for starters, the comic band, I think is winding down as a group. I don't know how big they are still in Japan, so they're not going to be traveling with BABYMETAL. So BABYMETAL is going to be needing more consistent bands, but what if they do stuff like this? Who wants an entire album of BABYMETAL just them on other people's stuff? If I was a metal band, right, and specifically if I had a male lead, and specifically if my male lead did a lot of growling or screaming, I would bring BABYMETAL in and tell their choreographer and tell the girls, we want Sue to sing and a little bit of Momo and you and Moa to sing as well, but we want you guys to dance to this, because this right here, this shit, the pop artist should be scared. Should be terrified. Because if they can do this with metal bands, they're screwed. Pop industry is screwed.
Get the fuck up! Get the fuck up! Why the system is- Get the fuck up! You're a puppet with a guy that screws up!
Like, I'm so proud of these girls because, for starters, they have been performing for 10 plus years. So anyone who thinks they're a gimmick, if you would have said they were a gimmick for the first 3-4 years, I would buy it. After 10 years, it's no longer a gimmick. It's an actual band. Okay? Because what was their gimmick 2013 when they were first starting out? What was their gimmick? What was the gimmick? Young Japanese girls that were in school? Was that their gimmick? Because guess what? They were young Japanese girls that were in... Like, every metal... Like, I am so hyped when I talk about BABYMETAL. Every metal purist who hates on these girls are jealous. Are absolutely jealous. But as a metal fan and as a metal fan and as somebody who loves this genre, I am prouder than all get out, and all of us should be very proud that these are the girls that are taking metal over. That these are the girls that are honing the future of metal for multiple reasons. I will get into this at the end of the video, and I love Bring Me the Horizon, because Bring Me the Horizon has been with BABYMETAL since, well, not even at day one, but since close to the beginning, like, towards their first album. Bring Me the Horizon and Dragon Force were one of the two groups, and Metallica were one of the three groups that signed off on these girls early on, followed by Rob Halford, Jonathan Davis, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Guns N' Roses have toured with them. Lady Gaga has done stuff with them. If you think they're not legit, you need to go talk to the artists who have actually been on the road with these girls. And again, after this video, I'm going to go on a huge rant, and I don't care if nobody sees it. I don't care if this doesn't get uploaded, because I have a rant I have to get on, because these girls need somebody like me to speak up for them. Because I know they won't do it themselves. I know a big part's coming up soon. God, I love this. I love this. I love this. I love this. And actually, this is a combination I never thought my head would work. Bring Me the Horizon and BABYMETAL. But it works so well. It works so well because Oli brings the, and the rest of the band bring the aggressive side. And then Bring Me the, and BABYMETAL is the calm, relaxed, well, the elegant side. But BABYMETAL also has that little aggression to them, too. And I love when Sue Metal hits those notes. I love it, I love it, I love it. I will say this, and I'm going to get so much heat for this. Flori Jansson might be the best pure singer. So here's my bet. Here's my thing. Flori Jansson is the best pure singer in metal. I would say the world, but it's a tall order to say that, but especially in metal. Singer. Tatiana is the best pure growler in metal. But Sue Metal, if I was a young girl, no, not young girl, if I was teaching a young girl who to look to sing, it would be Sue. because her ability to hold notes, her ability to be so powerful while feeling so light in her vocals is ridiculous. And her ability to encapsulate the feeling of the song within her vocals is unmatched. Unmatched. And she's been doing this since she was 13 years old. 13 years old. And I think that's what gets a lot of people upset with them, is that they were so young when they started, and they're so big, and they're going to get bigger. Because guess what? All these bands that I keep comparing them to, all these bands we keep talking about them to, they're younger than them. These girls are younger than those groups. The bands that are in their league right now, they're younger than them, which means in 20 years, it's going to be all them. And if they're, like all the other Japanese people, they're going to take damn good care of themselves for the next 20 years. I mean, this is their cardio right here.
This is your wake-up call. We're going down a rabbit hole. Are you ready?
Bring Me the Horizon, Kingslayer, featuring BABYMETAL. That's a mouthful. That is so hype. That is so good. That is such an amazing performance, an amazing live thing. I have a few questions about it. Like, I want to know, does Bring Me the Horizon always perform like that? Or did they elevate because they knew BABYMETAL was there in Tokyo with them? And they knew that they could let those girls down, because those girls, if you don't show up, those girls will. And those girls will make you look like a fool every single time. I believe, I don't know which member of it, but some member of Slipknot said that they toured, when they did their tour thing with BABYMETAL, that they are the hardest band to follow, because you have to bring your A game, because BABYMETAL is going to knock it out of the park every single time. And that's something I want to hammer into people about this band. These girls put everything into their performance. Everything. They put their sweat, tears. They care. This is going to sound extreme. They care more about this genre and more about this, what they do, than any group I have ever seen. These three girls, and Mo, Yui, when she was there, Yui still cares. Yui stepped down because of health reasons, so we can respect that. But Yui cared enough to put a lot of her life into doing this. And they care. They care so much that they've done so much for fans just to make them happier. Just because they want their fans to be happy. Their biggest worry... They were so elated when they did their show in France, that first big show that they ever did. They were worried. They were supposed to do a show, a venue, I think, for 5,000 people. They got bumped up to the 50,000 person stage. These are 15 and 13 at the time. These were kids. And they were terrified. They were worried the fans wouldn't like them. They weren't worried if they were going to sound good, because they were going to sound good. They're BABYMETAL. They're always going to sound good live, because they're Japanese. They're very precise with their... Even if it looks like chaos at sometimes, it's very precision chaos. Precise chaos is what BABYMETAL is. I just love these girls, and I love that Bring Me the Horizon brought them with them. I love it. 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 And I think I was going to go on a rant about them. Those of you who say they're a gimmick, shut up. They're not a gimmick. Not anymore. Again, if they would have folded up for 5 years, I would have said, yeah, it was just a gimmick band. Gimmick bands don't last. Very, very many of them don't last 10 plus years. Slipknot was called a gimmick band for a long time. But they're not a gimmick either. They wear a mask as a gimmick, but they are not a gimmick band. They just wear a mask. They wore a mask at the beginning to stay anonymous, but then people figured out Corey Taylor, so Corey Taylor. But these girls, like, as a metal artist, metal fan, we should be very proud that these are the girl. This is the band, or one of the bands that's going to be taking over the industry. The reason we should is, one, they don't do drugs. They don't run around talking about sex. They don't run around talking about bullshit. They do, however, sing about being yourself, expressing yourself in the way you want to, and being your own person, and making yourself proud. And that's something we can all agree with. And they are the most respectful girls I have ever seen. Performers I've ever seen. Even when they're doing interviews when they're young and they don't know anything the guy is saying, they sit there with a big smile on their face, nodding their head, being polite, because they know what it's about. These girls know what it's about. It's about us, the fans. They understand it. I bet you right now, Moa and Momo are practicing the choreography, and Sue is reading some, learning some language, a sentence in a language, so that when they go to their concert, one of their festival shows coming up, that they can speak in their native, at least a few words in their native language. I'm just saying, these girls are amazing. And Bring Me the Horizon is so awesome for bringing them with them. So awesome for having them in this. And I respect Bring Me the Horizon a lot, because they said that they will never do the song without BABYMETAL. Ever. There are a lot of bands out there that have songs that have features that will do it without the band that they featured with, or the artist they featured with. Bring Me the Horizon said they will never perform it without BABYMETAL. Because it loses all. I've never heard it without BABYMETAL, so I don't know. Technically, but I'm going to imagine it loses a lot without those girls. But, oh, YouTube, please let this go up. If you like this video, leave a like, comment down below, subscribe if you want to see more. Please, YouTube gods, please. Till next time. Goodbye, everybody.
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.